and Bits. I gotta get me more Kibbles and Bits.
Why they had problems. Celebrities doing voiceover commercials. There you have it, ladies and gentlemen. You know my first guest. In fact, come to think of it, she'll be my only guest here tonight from MTV. From I guess she's got a saucy new calendar out. She's also a supermodel for the Revlon Corporation. Coincidentally, you might remember me as Mr. Whipple. Please, if you would, ladies and gentlemen, give her a warm welcome. It's the very lovely, adoring Daisy Fuentes. Really great.
You look very nice too.
No, but you.
Not really.
You look great. And not only you look great here in person, you look not too bad right here. Ladies and gentlemen, have you seen this thing here? Look at that. It's the Daisy Fuentes calendar. Well, this is the first time you've actually ever visited us here on Stage 5.
It is.
Yeah, it's good to have you here.
Thank you. It's very nice to be here.
You have a little time
Where'd
off.
Where'd you get that?
I got this. This has been floating around around the offices quite a bit, I might add, the last couple of days. Ladies and gentlemen, all I can tell you is I wish there were more months than 12 in a year. My goodness. Now, when did you shoot this?
I don't know, but I didn't think anybody would really be looking at it like that when I shot it. Otherwise, I wouldn't have.
No, this is a beautiful calendar. These
thank
are beautiful, beautiful
you
shots.
Think so, you like
I really do, and I've studied it, believe
have
me.
You really? Thank you.
It's how long did it take you to shoot, and where did you shoot it?
2 days in Miami.
Oh, this is 2 days of work?
From Miami.
Hey, the rhythm is going to get you. You know what I like? I got to tell you which one I like right
which
here.
One do you
this
like?
One, this is one of my favorites.
Oh, yeah?
Take a look at that, folks.
Why is that?
Woo!
What do you particularly like about it, Greg?
Because I have that same suit.
Do you really? I bet you don't fill it out like that, though. You probably fill it out and, you know.
No, this is great. Did you
replace
was this? Certainly hope so.
I wasn't talking about the one you're thinking.
How do you know? where did so you had a good time doing this? Was it is it kind of uncomfortable because you're really I mean
it
some of these
really
shots.
It was really uncomfortable because as you know I mean most of the models are always used to doing this kind
of
stuff. They do
of
the
course.
Lingerie stuff.
You
they're constantly
the
posing half naked. I don't usually do this kind of stuff. I mean the only modeling I've done really is like with Revlon or for TV commercials that I've done because of my television work. So this is the first time I actually had to basically take a lot off.
Yeah. And who called you about it? I mean, how did it get started, this whole thing?
Landmark basically asked me if I was interested in doing it, and I thought, well, why not? Everybody else has one. I might as well have one, too.
Now, I know when you look at one of these, it's not just like some guy with a Polaroid shooting you here. This is like you got a big crew of people standing around.
Yeah.
It's uncomfortable to wear...
No, I kind of like it when people are standing around watching me naked. It's kind of cool.
I'll volunteer. Anybody else with me?
Of course it's uncomfortable.
It is.
How would you feel?
I don't know.
Well,
I haven't been naked in any calendar.
Why don't you strip down to your underwear and walk around here a little bit and see how it feels?
Damn
you
thing
can't even
stuck.
Do it. You can't even do it, can you?
Let me ask you this. What is your family? What is your, what's the family? I know you're close with your family, aren't
yes,
you?
Yes, very close.
Very close
yes.
to your family. You have a big family?
No, not really. Grandparents, the two set of grandparents, my parents, and my sister and I.
Yes, and you're close with, and your dad, are you close with your dad?
Yeah.
And what did he think? Because, you know, the dad, the daughter relationship, always unusual. What did he think about this whole
he
thing?
He thinks I got it from him. You know.
Got what from him?
The ability to pose in front of a camera.
Oh.
And to... Not like my
definitely
breath.
Definitely parts he didn't get
you're
from you.
You're thinking I got like my breath from my dad, aren't you? No.
So he was okay with it.
He was okay with it. Oh, he hasn't really seen
Daisy.
The whole
thing. So dad doesn't know
well,
about it.
Well, there's
this
nothing show. Really bad in it. It's just sex, so you can't like see any,
it's
you
good-looking
know,
stuff.
Privates or anything.
Good-looking stuff,
yeah,
as far as
you.
I'm concerned. Is it true you got him a convertible, your dad?
I did. I got him a car.
Starting to butter him up for the release of this thing, huh?
Yeah, you know, I figured he couldn't really say anything, and if he does, I'll take the car back.
Right, right. I've read somewhere that you said like Latin families are actually very, very close. Is that true?
Yeah, we are. I mean, I still go back home, and my mom still tells me what to eat and how to dress and. You know, when I'm doing right and wrong, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Do they see you on MTV?
Yeah.
You know, ladies and gentlemen, this is one of the largest stars we're looking at from the music television world. That's true, right? Both here in the U.S. and down
in Latin America.
It is absolutely amazing. is there a difference in terms of the fans down there and how they respond to you, and here in the U.S.?
I really have had great experiences with fans. I haven't had any scary, nasty moment. Like, you know, some people say with like stalkers and stuff like that. Everybody's been great, but there is a slight difference, I think. Latin people are more, I don't really know how to say it, just a little bit more...
Touchy-feely?
A little hotter, a little hot-blooded, you
right.
know? And I think we tend to be a little bit friendlier sometimes. Then the difference would be, like, for example, if you're in Latin America, they feel like they can almost come down and sit and have dinner with you.
Right.
And talk to you about your family, and they practically become part of your family for the few minutes that you're talking with them.
Right. Are you okay with that?
That's cool, because they're harmless.
Yeah,
because they're very polite for the most part, and they're very nice.
Yeah.
But in New York, for example, where I spend a lot of my time, it's different, because it's just somebody will just walk down the street and recognize and say, oh, yo, you're the chick from M2 or stuff, and keep walking.
Right.
So there's a little bit of a difference in the recognition, but nevertheless, it's lovely.
Not a very warm greeting from the New Yorkers.
Oh, that's very warm for New Yorkers.
Yeah.
That's very warm.
That's when they're feeling good.
That's when I know. I feel so proud. I say, oh, my God. You look good.
If you haven't seen Daisy here down in Latin America, this is what it looks like. It always looks a little different than what you see here. Look at this. This is a little bit different.
Bienvenidos al Top 20 MTV. Yo soy Daisy Fuentes. Por favor, prepárense para comenzar las 2 horas llenas de acción, donde contaremos del 20 al número 1 los hits de la semana. Hoy veremos si Meatloaf logra aplastar a los Pet Shop Boys despojándolos del puesto número 1.
Okay. Sí. Sí, esto está bien. Meatloaf. That's the only Spanish I know. My brother used to say it all the time around the house. He didn't speak any Spanish, but he'd go, sí, tu padre en para mamá, donés ese día de la madre. What's that mean?
Absolutely nothing.
Thank you. How did you get the job with MTV?
Oh, I was doing, I was a weather anchor for one of the Spanish stations in New York.
Sí.
And I kind of thought it was a little too serious. I learned enough there,
right.
And I put a tape together because I really wanted to do MTV. I mean, that's what I would watch at home, and I love music. I mean, music is around me all the time, so I thought, my God, what a great gig it would be just to, you know, to be part of this channel.
And not report on the weather.
Exactly. I mean, you know, the whole Nueva York, Nueva Jersey, Connecticut thing just kind of, like, got tired, and I thought, my God, I want to talk about Meatloaf, you know? And I sent them a tape of me doing the weather in Spanish with a letter begging them for an audition, basically, and promising them that I did speak English to please just give me an audition. And about 7 months later, they called me for the Spanish pilot.
So you must have thought in that seven-month period, this thing's over. I don't have a chance.
I was completely sure that the tape was trashed.
Right.
Yeah.
And you didn't miss the weather forecasting at all, because I understand you that wasn't something you really excelled at, was it, Daisy?
I was very good at it.
You were?
I had no clue what I was talking about.
Yeah.
But people didn't know that, necessarily, when they were watching it.
Yeah. I read that you would watch the Weather Channel to get your weather updates in terms of what was happening. So.
I did. I would listen to the radio. I would listen to 1010 Winds in New York. And I would get the weather for the rest of the week and for that night and for the next day. And then basically I would say it later on the 6 o'clock news.
We have to do a quick break. We'll be right back with Daisy Fuentes after this.
Mine smells funny.
Yeah, it does.
It's funny because
bad breath. And that's all you've got to confess?
Ah!
You're watching Comedy Central.
This part of the brain controls the subject's emotions.
Hey, get off my lawn!
This part controls hunger.
Hey, you gonna eat that?
This controls sexual impulses. This controls rational thought.
Why would I buy a 32-bit system for $300 when I can get a 64-bit Jaguar system for $149?
Atari Jaguar 64-bit, $149.
Knock it off!
Not just any drain opener can butt through a tubby.
The Gin Blossoms Till I Hear It From You, only on MTV. You'd think you were watching VH1, but we have a band from Australia coming up in just a little bit. They came over to the U.S. for a couple of dates that literally ended with a bang because they're playing a free show down at the Santa Monica Pier in Santa Monica, California, and lead singer Daniel Johns was pegged in the head with a bottle. If you can believe that, this sweet child, only 15, 16 years old, is nailed in the head with a sharp piece of glass. He had to go to the hospital, and now they've returned to Australia to fit in a little bit of high school, and they're going to be back in the U.S. starting November 13th to do a few dates with the Red Hot Chili Peppers, so that's going to be a very exciting show. We will keep you filled in with exact dates and details. It's only going to be on MTV, people, so stay here for an Australian import. I'll play Cute.
Summer's over. You thought you'd slip into the same old routine. Well, guess again, Pally.
Ding dong! MTV calling!
MTV needs a new place to crash. Could be yours if you're lucky.
Hey! This isn't quilted!
Your home becomes the center of the universe when MTV comes to you. So stock the fridge and hide your valuables.
It's cool if I borrow these, right?
It's MTV invades your space. The whole channel relocates to your place for one full day of programming. MTV News, singled out, surprise celebrity guests, and a special house party edition of The Grind from your backyard.
We are coming at you live from Kenny's backyard. Ew! Who let the dog out?
Invite 100 of your closest friends. We'll even throw in 25 grand to cover incidental stuff. To enter, send your name, age, address, and daytime phone number on a postcard to MTV Invades Your Space Contest, P.O. Box 1211, Radio City Station, New York, New York, 10101, or invest 65 cents and call 1-900-860-3333. Let MTV invade your space. You'll just love what we do to the place.
Hey, man, you got some more nachos?
This MTV contest is brought to you by Snickers. Hungry? Why wait? And Levi's 501 Jeans. Be your own reason.
Guys, I've said this 4 years in a row, but this year, we're not only going back to the big one, we're going to win it. No one is leaving this room until we figure out how. No one.
Not going anywhere for a while? Grab a Snickers, because nothing will hold you over like peanuts, caramel, and milk chocolate.
Better give me one, too.
Hungry? Why wait?
Michael Myers has come back to kill.
On Friday, September 29th, the final confrontation begins. Halloween, The Curse of Michael Myers, rated R, now playing.
I know there really is something about being a soldier. It started the moment I got here. The word can't vanished. This was advanced training. This was the training I came in for. My folks are proud of what I've done. I'm proud of who I am. I'm a soldier.
I don't know. Someone sees you buying one or carrying one. It's embarrassing.
Get real. If you're not ready to deal with condoms, you're not ready for sex.
Trojan latex condoms help reduce the risk.
Imagine a CD-ROM that immerses you into a wicked predicament.
A pawn in the war to control the human mind.
You're playing Burn Cycle.
The CD-ROM action-adventure game.
You experience
mind-expanding extended gameplay.
You navigate fantastic 3D worlds.
The end game is a shocking conclusion. Use your brain or lose your mind.
Burn Cycle, the CD-ROM action-adventure game.
On sale in software stores now.
One hair color that really pops, color with more punch, doesn't it?
Now, now list the your name. Other
champions. Yeah. Thank you. Modern chemistry, which really got its start during the Renaissance in the laboratories of, that's right, the alchemists. In fact, some historians have even suggested that the very icon of modern science, Sir Isaac Newton, may have died as a result of poisoning caused by his own alchemy experiments, which involved handling mercury in his bare hands. Now, if any of our viewers know how to turn lead into gold without that sort of risk, please feel free to drop me a personal note, care of the Discovery Channel, in a well-sealed envelope, of course. And that's it for this edition of Beyond 2000. If none of the mail pans out, then I'll see you again next time. I'm Henry Tenenbaum. So long.
Coming up next, engage in aerial dogfights and fly in military formation on Next Step. Then beautiful sleek cheetahs mew like kittens and accelerate like rockets on Wild Discovery. Explore your world on the Discovery Channel. This program is brought to you in part by Lincoln Mercury and the complete line of 96 Mercury automobiles.
Imagine hearing the call of the road, not the road itself. Imagine having the world at your fingertips. Imagine worrying less and enjoying more. Imagine an automobile so precisely engineered it feels as if it were formed from a single piece of steel. Introducing the all-new 1996 Mercury Sable.
When Dave Thomas created Wendy's Spicy Chicken Sandwich, he used a whole breast fillet seasoned with his own blend of pepper and spices, but did he go too far?
Very spicy.
Wimp. It's perfect.
Depends on who you ask. Try Wendy's Spicy Chicken Sandwich.
United Way is continually evolving to meet the changing needs of America's urban, rural, and suburban communities. Your generosity can make the great American dream a possibility for the millions who need a second chance or a helping hand to get them back on their feet.
Tonight on Wild Discovery, when speed means survival, to the fastest goes the prize.
Hunters.
The chase is on. Explore their world on Wild Discovery. Tonight at 8 Eastern, 7 Central, explore. On the Discovery Channel.
Did you say anything like that?
Not. Attorney General Robert Kennedy.
I know that's pretty ridiculous.
Teamsters boss Jimmy Hoffa.
I would question whether or not Mr. Kennedy has anything concerning Jimmy Hoffa that isn't already public knowledge.
At war on the Senate floor. Was it a congressional investigation or a personal vendetta? See Rivals, RFK and Hoffa, tonight at 10 Eastern, 9 Central, only on the Discovery Channel.
Beginning Monday on Wild Discovery, legless, carnivorous, aquatic, and vicious. To some, creepy. To others, cool.
Wild.
Do you hate snakes, gators, lizards, real big lizards?
Watch out.
Every weeknight, all week. Don't look away if you're smart. Dinosaur Descendants.
Wild.
On Wild Discovery. Beginning Monday at 8 Eastern, 7 Central on the Discovery Channel.
Explore
your world.
Discover Earth's mysterious past. Brought to life. Relive the origins of our world and begin an unbelievable journey back. Don't miss Planet of Life. Beginning Monday at 9 Eastern, 8 Central on the Discovery Channel.
The Discovery Channel. Weekday. Beginning at 5 Eastern. Central.
Ted Reinstein, and this is the Pond on the Mechanic Show.
Eastern, 4 Central. Weekday wings, 6 Eastern, 5 Central. Discovery Show. Beyond 2000, 7 Eastern, 6 Central. Going live. Cut and wait. Next step, 7:30 Eastern, 6:30 Central.
And a panic alarm, computer light, and number 2.
Exploring your world.
A kill on the other guy without killing the other guy. That is the next step in flying.
That sounds like a challenge to me.
When you're dealing with burn wounds and when patients with extensive injuries, it's really a race against time to save their life.
Scientists and physicians have developed a new way to grow skin.
Paul and Phil, along with this frisky boy, it's Barney the Answer Dog, here to help us demonstrate ultrasonic fences and flea collars and other technological advances for your pets.
Ever walk into a military surplus store and try to buy a G-suit? That's one of those gravity suits worn by fighter pilots. It can't be done. I'm Richard Hart. Welcome to the next step in technology. There is an American company working to develop a G-suit for civilians, though. Why? Because it's their goal to make as real as possible for you and me the experience of a fighter pilot. They're called Air Combat USA, and they have fighters, they have lasers, they have G-suits. And this ain't no video game.
All right, tally-ho, that's the lab. We got the speed. You guys are going to be lunch meat.
He's behind us, he's behind us.
Feet over the Pacific is the danger zone, an area reserved for ground grunts with $600 of discretionary income who want to become top guns. Up here, you can scream down out of the sun, jinx left, pull 6 G's, line up an unsuspecting jester, and squeeze off a burst that'll pucker his nomad. And you can prove it all later with a videotape provided by Air Combat USA. They do everything possible to make you believe Tom Cruise has nothing on you.
To make air combat flying absolutely as real as possible, short of the lead coming through the cockpit. And if we can figure out how to do that without killing somebody, we'll do that too.
Mike Blackstone formed Air Combat USA back in 1988. He uses fully aerobatic Italian Marchetti 260s, fighter trainers capable of pulling 6 positive and 3 negative Gs. His instructor pilots are former military jocks, many of whom actually went through the Navy's Top Gun school at Miramar. That was the easy part. The hard part was devising a system that proved, without a doubt, who shot whom in a dogfight.
What it does is it looks for an aircraft in a little spot out there that's roughly 25 feet in diameter.
The thing that we're looking for is we want to get him about 30 mils across in the gunsight, which is where he is right now.
And if the aircraft is occupying that space, then the two aircraft can communicate electronically.
Our light sensing unit here is gathering the light from that lead airplane.
There are strobes, rotating beacons, radio transmissions, any type of energy emanating from that aircraft coming back towards my aircraft. If it goes down the tube of my detector and it sees it, it'll close the switch and complete the transaction and cause a kill.
Now, if you'll squeeze the trigger, you'll see what happens.
There it is, yeah.
And that's what the smoke looks like.
Why smoke?
Realism. Realism. Normally, airplanes, when they get shot down, they just don't, the engine doesn't stop and the guy steps over the side, the airplane bursts into smoke and flame. This is the closest we can do without bursting into flame.
So, feeling the need for speed, I grabbed my suit, my chute, my skid lid.
Who's coming in for a color?
And headed out for a Richard Hart smoke test. Literally. If only I hadn't had that cheeseburger.
Put your shoe down and shut up.
You ain't cheating, you ain't trying.
My instructor is Robert Kunstman, Hollywood in air combat parlance. They call me the Hurler for reasons that shall remain private. With two other Marchettis, Jester and Maverick, we head out into the danger zone. One of the real beauties of the air combat experience is that you, no matter if you can't even park your Toyota, actually fly the airplane. Yes, at 5,000 feet with a hard deck of 1,000, you're given the stick and shown how to make a kill.
Now, at this distance, this range, how many degrees of latitude left and right do we have?
We can go from here to here, okay? That's about a 50-mil spread. Okay, now I want you to go ahead and put the gun sight on him. There we go. Now squeeze the trigger. There's the cone, and there's the screw. All right.
Just winged us. Well, what if we took a little evasive action? Now try and get him.
That sounds like a challenge to me.
I'll take it.
Okay, Rich, put him in the sight now. Put him in the sight. There it is.
The unique tracking system that senses firing in reverse has a patent pending on it. They're working on a real G-suit, and you can even go on a bombing run. Hey, short of joining the Navy, this is as close as you or I will ever get to the real thing.
We have spoke.
Just remember one thing, Gomer. Bring your bark bag.
Hey, how about a cheeseburger right about now?
Next up, we don't have anti-gravity, but we do have anti-noise. Enjoy the sound of silence and farms that grow human body parts from skin to bones.
This program is brought to you in part by Lincoln Mercury and the complete line of 96 Mercury automobiles.
Imagine an automobile engineered to such precise tolerances, it feels as if it were formed from a single piece of steel. Introducing the all-new 1996 Mercury Sable. The all-new Mercury Sable. Imagine something better.
Imagine yourself in a Mercury.
Now available, the Wing CD-ROM Collection. From Midway to Vietnam and beyond, you can relive the battles and explore all the amazing aircraft through the power of Discovery Channel Multimedia. The Wing CD-ROM Collection, three landmark aviation titles including Wings Over Europe, where you can examine crucial air battles and explore legendary planes. Wings Midway to Hiroshima, with stunning animations of combat techniques and virtual reality airfields. And Wings Korea to Vietnam, with live-action video and 3D aircraft models. Each disc also has its own flight simulator missions. Call now to order the Wing CD-ROM collection and get a fourth Discovery CD-ROM, Normandy the Great Crusade, absolutely free. And a free Wings baseball hat, all for only $99.95. The entire collection will be sent to you in this commemorative Wings leatherette display case. Call 1-800-266-2690.
Next on Wild Discovery, when speed means survival, to the fastest goes the prize.
Hunters.
The chase is on. Explore their world on Wild Discovery. Next, explore on the Discovery Channel.
Did you say anything like that?
Attorney General Robert Kennedy.
Hey, oh, that's pretty ridiculous.
Teamsters boss Jimmy Hoffa. See Rivals, RFK and Hoffa, tonight at 10 Eastern, 9 Central, only on the Discovery Channel.
Imagine this. One day you're annoyed by the sound of a low-flying jet, so you point this dish up at the sky and cancel the jet noise with anti-noise. It's not science fiction. Right now, the state of California is testing the idea of lining highways with active anti-noise walls. We say active because the walls would vibrate and cancel out the sounds of cars. We'll explain that now, but I want you to pay careful attention to the sounds you're about to hear and notice the difference between what you hear and don't hear.
the last 10 years, the average noise level in our lives has increased by a factor of 10. And it isn't going to disappear anytime soon. So who are you going to call?
Noise Busters. Now, there isn't any technology so good that it'll completely eliminate the sound yet. But it's getting kind of close.
When you were in the presidential helicopter trying to communicate with the president, what would happen is the helicopter noise would interfere with your communications.
I hate it when that happens. He does, too. Okay, so you can kill helicopter noise?
Yeah, why don't you sit in that seat and you'll see how it works. These microphones here pick up the noise, and they would normally be mounted in the back of the seat, and these speakers generate the anti-noise, and they create a sphere of silence around your head.
That's amazing. Let me do this.
I'm going to let you hear exactly what my ear is picking up. Now, notice how quiet it is here, and...
cancellation works this way. Every sound generates a wave that can be seen on an oscilloscope. If you generate another wave that has opposite peaks and valleys, a mirror image, and then send it through a loudspeaker, the two sounds will collide and largely cancel each other out within milliseconds.
This is a siren in an emergency vehicle. This is what you would hear if you were driving an emergency vehicle or an ambulance, a fire engine.
If you create the sphere of silence within, say, a headset, you can cancel out just about any sound you want.
So what we do here is we create a headset for the driver, and you put that on. And what happens if you turn off the cancellation, you'll see the dramatic effect.
Wow.
Personal noise cancellation with the use of headphones is one way to quiet your world. Another way is to go right to the source.
Let's take a moment to look up your tailpipe. This is a typical exhaust. The noise comes out here. This system uses a microphone to pick up the noise, send it through a computer that processes it, and generates anti-noise with two 8-inch speakers here, sending it out this pipe. Where the two meet, the noise is pretty much canceled.
A sensor upstream near the engine samples the sound wave, and through a microchip analog to digital converter, creates an opposite blueprint. The mirror image is converted back to an analog sound wave, amplified and pumped into speakers just ahead of the traveling tailpipe noise, creating a yin-yang kind of a sound pattern collision. The whole thing takes a fraction of a second, and the result is a quiet car without a conventional muffler.
This is so weird because we're sitting here talking in normal voices about 2 feet from a vacuum cleaner, and we can understand each other.
The same technology can be used to clean up noise from household appliances.
How does the old one sound?
Much louder.
And what is this?
This is a power transformer, and as you can hear, they're really noisy and they disturb people.
Low-frequency vibration is another irritating source of noise. It can be eliminated by generating the opposite vibrations with the use of piezoelectric ceramic patches.
What can you do?
Cancel it. Watch.
Whoa! Once more. And on.
Companies like NCT, along with Motorola, Bose, and others, are rapidly developing active noise-canceling technologies. Noiseless airline cabins and automobile interiors using existing stereo systems are just around the corner. The next step will be putting to rest once and for all those jackhammers, snowblowers, and jet engines that rattle our lives.
Here they are, the world's first personal noise busters from Noise Cancellation Technologies. They look like ordinary walk-person headphones, except that in addition to the speakers inside, there are microphones on the outside. They pick up any offending sound and send it into this little computer, which you wear on your belt, battery-operated. This generates the anti-noise, which travels back up to the headphones, and effectively, much of it is canceled. They cost $149 or less, and they actually have noise reduction, not noise cancellation. It doesn't eliminate it entirely. But for a long trip with a droning airplane engine, it's a sound idea.
Still to come, this man's life was saved by the medical miracle of skin farming. And the Answer Guys have a solution for that wayward pooch.
If I had to choose one moment to live my whole life through, it would be that tender moment. But moment I met you.
The very first sip of St. Pauli Girl's rich imported taste, you know you found something special.
One moment.
Next, meet a killer that mews like a kitten on Wild Discovery. Then see technology that could give sight to the blind on Beyond 2000. And Bobby Kennedy seeks to destroy Jimmy Hoffa on the premiere of Rivals, coming up on the Discovery Channel.
The 1996 models are here at Wally McCarthy's Oldsmobile in Richfield, and you know what that means? That means it's closeout time on all the 95 models. A $1,000 price reduction on a 98. An absolutely unheard of $1,500 price reduction on a Sierra. So now you can buy for as low as $12,995. Folks, we invite you to come on in. The closeout super sale is going on right now at Wally McCarthy's Oldsmobile in Richfield, 494 Penn Avenue South.
What is Relax the Back?
Would you repeat the question?
Relax the Back is the store for your good or bad back. Hundreds of products for the neck and back.
Relax the Back. Is that new,
For the office. For the home. For the bed. For the body. We're just what the doctor ordered.
That's comforting.
Yes, and relaxing. Relax the Back. The best of everything for your back.
Me in there, there was essentially no hope. They, you know, told my family and that I would not make it through the night. There was no maybe. It was positively not.
No one believed Michael Versich would live when he entered the University of California San Diego Medical Center. He had burns over 95% of his body. This picture shows the charred remains of his motorhome that blew up on July 4th while he was inside.
When you're dealing with burn wounds and when patients with extensive injuries, it's really a race against time to save their life.
6 months, 10 surgeries, and $2 million in hospital bills later, Michael survived. Part of his miraculous recovery is due to a new medical procedure that may revolutionize burn treatment. Scientists and physicians have developed a new way to grow skin.
Being able to grow skin quickly is so important to burn patients because of the process of recovery. Let's say that this area is the only part of a body not burned. A surgeon has to remove a patch, transplant it to an affected area of the body, and wait for this to replenish itself, and then do the whole thing again. Surgery after surgery, week after week, it can take excruciating months. And in the meantime, every part of the body that's not covered by skin has to be protected by something. No solution has been ideal so far, and frankly, in most cases, that covering is donated from people who've already died. Cadaver skin.
How you doing, okay?
The problem is this. There isn't a large enough supply of cadaver skin. Furthermore, a patient could be subjected to transmitted diseases, and the body rejects it within 2 weeks, which means new cadaver skin constantly has to be reapplied.
During this process, they're extremely sick. The wound care is monumental. It's just tremendous hours spent in wound care because you're constantly replacing this stuff.
What Michael received on his stomach was one of the first pieces of temporary skin that was not from a cadaver. Instead, it was grown in a laboratory. This test tube skin is made entirely of human tissue. It carries no infection, and best of all, it won't be rejected for months.
We see this as a material which could be applied just once, we think. It won't be rejected and could seal the wound for 6 months.
Dr. Hansborough took his idea to a small company called Advanced Tissue Sciences to develop the next step. ATS is the world's first company founded on that marvelous human organ we call skin.
If you asked somebody 8 to 10 years ago about skin, they would have said, oh, it's basically a cover. It's not a very exciting tissue. And now we know that it's a very complex and very, very exciting tissue. It's one of the few tissues that continues to grow and proliferate normally your entire life.
What's going on here is something that's never even been attempted before. Not just making cells reproduce themselves, but human cells on a large scale and three-dimensionally. It's as close as we've ever come to making human skin outside the body.
The cells grow on a framework and form tissue. The framework then dissolves, leaving nothing but human skin. All of the skin growing for human use is still in the testing stages. However, their first product is something that will help animals now. This is Skin Square, tiny squares of skin that can be used to test everything from baby products to cosmetics, eliminating the need to test on animals.
It actually helps product formulators make products milder right on the lab bench and test it in a few hours to see whether or not the product is going to be milder and they're going to be able to go and with baby products and cosmetics and the like, be able to continuously make their products safer, milder for the consumer.
The next step is to take what they have learned from growing skin and attempt to grow other organs, bone and cartilage. This ear is the first ever to be grown in a laboratory. It's not synthetic, not artificial. It was created using real human skin and cartilage.
Because there isn't any cookbook for what we're doing. There isn't a recipe for growing human tissue. So understanding how we grow skin, going from that to cartilage, moving then to bone, every time we're learning something new, we could apply it to the next tissue.
For future burn victims, this new skin might be the difference between life and death. It also can help cut down the $5,000 a day hospital bills.
Oh, Michael suffered burns over about 95% of his body, so he had an amazing recovery, although he came very close to not making it several times.
Michael's advice to others, however, is to rely not on the technology, but on something maybe even more important.
The bottom line is determination, you know, and I just, you know, never gave up.
At the time of his accident, Michael Versich had known Nicole for less than a month. Yet throughout his many surgeries and all those months in the hospital, she remained by his side nearly every evening. And the first thing they did when he left the hospital was get married.
Next, a pet project from Paul and Phil, and introducing the answer dog.
This program is brought to you in part by Lincoln Mercury and the complete line of 96 Mercury automobiles.
Imagine hearing the call of the road, not the road itself. Imagine having the world at your fingertips. Imagine worrying less and enjoying more. Imagine an automobile so precisely engineered it feels as if it were formed from a single piece of steel. Introducing the all-new 1996 Mercury Sable.
Imagine yourself in a Mercury.
Sprint Sense International gives you great rates to countries all over the world. What more could you want?
How about some cash?
Cash would be good. Yes, some cash back.
Presenting Sprint Sense International with something new, cash back. Call now for these simply great rates on calls to countries all around the world. Plus, get rewarded with 10% cash back for every dollar you spend.
For me, that would be at least $100 a year.
Cash back on all my calls to Ireland?
There's no limit to the amount of cash back you can earn. Month after month, you'll see your cash add up, so it pays to stay with Sprint. Call now and we'll even switch you for free.
What about domestic cards?
You'll get cash back on domestic calls, too. And with Sprint Sense International, you'll get a great 10 cents a minute rate on every state-to-state call. So call now.
Cash back would be great.
Good idea.
Cash back. It's one phrase that's understood around the world. Get simply great rates now and 10% cash back every year.
Call now. 1-800-227-2319.
Next on Wild Discovery, when speed means survival, to the fastest goes the prize.
Hunters.
The chase is on. Explore their world on Wild Discovery. Next, explore on the Discovery Channel.
This is Samara. She is not a pet. She is a wildcat, a carolco, which is found in Africa and parts of the Middle East. And Lynn Myers brought her down from Marine World Africa, USA, today because Samara wanted to meet Barney. Not the dinosaur, Barney the dog. He is the answer guy's pet. And I guess that makes him the answer dog.
I'm Paul.
And I'm Phil. We're the answer guys, along with Barney, the answer dog.
Barney's a pure-blooded chihuahua, but we've been feeding him a special mixture of vitamins and minerals that we've whipped up in the answer lab.
We like to call it answer chow, and hope to see it on your grocer's shelves soon.
Barney's going to help us demonstrate the next step in high-tech pet products. We start off with this. This is the automatic pet door from a company called High-Tech Pet Products.
We've rigged up a demo model here to show you how it works. It's a pet door that opens and closes automatically, like an electric car window.
It does it when your pet approaches wearing this special special collar. It emits an ultrasonic signal that the door reads as they're coming up, and then goes whoop right back down when they're through.